In this mixing masterclass, we're looking at EQ and a couple of basic EQ techniques that can help get things moving with your mix. EQ is one of the most important mixing tools and also one that's quite easy to get wrong. Remember, there is no requirement to EQ everything, and many would argue that you should use the minimum amount of EQ that you can. That said, we usually use EQ in a corrective or enhancing capacity, and at the mixing stage, we combine it with level balancing to help everything fit together. In this tutorial, we'll be looking at two core techniques, sweeping and filtering, that can help you focus your EQing by finding the frequencies you actually want to process. Sweeping requires a parametric EQ with a peak shape band and an adjustable Q. It relies on the fact that we find it much easier to distinguish a narrow band of boosted frequencies, and we can use this phenomenon to pinpoint areas and frequencies we want to boost or cut. We've inserted a suitable EQ plugin across our bass part, activating a parametric band and setting the bandwidth quite narrow, as is set to about 10. Now add plenty of gain. Here we've boosted by about 15 dB. By adjusting or sweeping the frequency as we listen to the part, we can zone in on its significant frequencies. You can do this quite quickly initially, and if you find that it's hard to pick out important frequencies, try widening the bandwidth until you find roughly the right area, then narrow the bandwidth again to really focus on a specific zone. Listening to our bass part, there's one high frequency in particular that sticks out too much. By sweeping, we've narrowed this down to about 230 Hz. And in this instance, we've decided to apply a minus 9 dB cut at this frequency with a broader bandwidth. Now let's try our blended drum stem. We've swept the low frequencies and found the body of the snare at about 205 Hz, and the snare knock at around 338 Hz. On this occasion, we're going to boost just the body. We've set a wider, more natural shape peak, Q is about 7, with about 6 dB of boost. Now let's try the filtering technique. This relies on temporarily removing frequencies so you can better hear a specific frequency range, and can be particularly effective when you're EQing more complex sounds or pre-blended stems or submixes, like our blended beat stem. Here we've activated a low-pass filter with a medium slope, 24 dB per octave, and a low Q, about 0.5, so the filter shouldn't add any misleading resonance. By lowering the cutoff frequency, we're not distracted by the mid and upper frequencies, and with the cutoff at about 600 Hz, we can hear the body frequencies for the kick, snare, congas, and cowbell. We can now use the sweeping technique to pinpoint exact frequencies. Once you're happy you found the areas you want to process, simply bypass or remove the low-pass filter.